In our Women and Work segment, Diane Mocha talks to women who wonder if they should leave the workforce because too much of their paycheck is going to childcare. Here's that report.
The average cost of childcare is more than $9,000 a year, according to a report from Childcare Aware of America. And The Atlantic says it can get as high as $23,000 for one baby in places like Seattle, where that price tag eats up 62% of the median single-parent income. Some mothers conclude it's just not worth it to work if the daycare nanny is taking that big of a chunk until they consider some other factors.
I wanted the intellectual stimulation of having a full-time job, so I needed the variety.
Cynthia Kramer is a married mother of two young girls who was eager to get back to work after her three-month maternity leave.
I just needed more and to see other people as well.
Cynthia had her parents and her friend each taking turns watching her baby. But when her friend was no longer available and Cynthia had a second daughter and got a new job further away, daycare became a necessity.
I interviewed maybe four daycare places and picked the one that I liked the best, that had, fit my philosophy.
She says she never felt the guilt some moms experience while being away from their kids at work, but she started to question if her decision made financial sense.
Oh, it's not affordable. I mean, I had another job and my entire job went to daycare. And so I had to decide, was it worth it or not?
With a master's in library science, Cynthia could find a better paying job. But many other moms with fewer choices, like Susan Contreras, are stuck losing much of their wages to the growing cost of childcare, which hit an all-time high in 2018, according to the latest study by care.com.
My last couple kids went to the daycare, so it's hard. It's not easy.
Was it affordable? Did you sometimes feel like half your check was going to daycare?
Yes, this is very expensive.
That reality often surprises new mothers, according to the care.com survey, and convinces 25% of them to leave the workforce. But the Center for American Progress says if parents quit working to stay home with their children, they can lose more money than they realize in future earning potential and retirement accounts that sit stagnant for years with no contributions and diminished growth. So many mothers lean into their careers even when sending their toddler to daycare costs more than their mortgage or college tuition.
Is this affordable? Is it worth it?
I decided over the long term it is. Because even if most of your job goes to daycare, you still get like health insurance and things like that. And then again, you get the development and you have the experience so that you can still advance.
Of course, the financial calculations don't take into account the emotional toll on women like Emily Pastor, who would prefer to be home with their children despite the loss of income now and in the future.
I wanted to be a really hands-on parent. I've always known I wanted to be a parent. So even though I'd put so much time and effort into my legal career, at that point I walked away and I was okay with it.
Regardless of their choices to work or stay home, moms agree childcare costs are a problem, and politicians are tripping over themselves to propose solutions. Women are tired of waiting and are finding their own remedies, like getting help from family, working hours opposite their spouse, and trading childcare with other mothers.